My name's Casey Nicholson. My background is in radiology, and I've been here at TGMC for about 4 months now. I'm actually a registered radiation therapist. So we work with radiation oncologists, so that's people, patients who have cancer. We treat their cancer with radiation. I actually had no idea what I wanted to do when I went to college. I went to college on an athletic scholarship. So my freshman year of college, we got to take this test that would help us choose what we could be best at based off of what we like, what we're interested in. And I took this test and it told me to be a chemical engineer or a nuclear medicine tech. And I was actually going to ULM at the time, and they did not have a chemical engineering program, so I decided to go into nuclear medicine. So I actually talked with a guidance counselor, and they told me that I needed to go to rad tech school. So I applied to rad tech school, and I went through my first year. My second year, we started going through the different specializations, and nuclear medicine is one of them. And I got in there and decided, oh my goodness, this is not what I want to do. Well, my next rotation after that was actually radiation therapy. And the moment that I walked into the door, I knew I want to be a radiation therapist. And so that's kind of what helped guide my choice into becoming a radiation therapist. Math and science, and particularly physics, and then also geometry. When you're a radiation therapist, you don't realize how much you use geometry and getting those beams, that radiation, perpendicular or parallel to the patient. My favorite thing about the job was when somebody would get a positive result. They would come back and tell us that their scans came back clean or that their labs came back and they're cancer free. And so getting to celebrate with them and through their survivorship was probably my favorite part of being a radiation therapist. The challenges of being a radiation therapist were the patients are very sick, they're in pain, and sometimes they do pass away. You become family with them, you become family with their family, and so it is hard to see someone in pain and then also to see their families in pain once they've lost their family members. So there are a lot of things that you can do with a radiology background, a radiation therapy background. Here at Terrebonne General, I am a clinical educator for the ancillary services. So that's the radiology department, the respiratory therapy department, and then with the CNAs. As a new person, when you first come out of school or you first start a new job, that can be very intimidating. And one part of my new job is that I get to help people get oriented to their new careers, to the hospital, and I find that very rewarding since I know how hard it is to be a new therapist. You can travel, you can leave your family, and you can go all over, and they definitely make more money than somebody who may stay home. That's definitely a personal decision that you have to do. I have a family, so I decided to stay home. The biggest piece of advice that I would give you is to never stop learning. We're always growing. There's always new things to learn. There's always better ways to do things, so you can never stop learning.